Mary L. Trump may have lived a quiet life before this past summer, but that's no longer the case, particularly after she set the world on fire with her bombshell book about her uncle, Donald Trump, Too Much and Never Enough. Since the book was released in August, people have been flocking to Twitter to see what she has to say next about the president, and during debate night, she did not disappoint. Before the event, Mary tweeted, "Hang tight, everybody. If we stick together, it's all going to be okay. Vote." Those words turned out to be more prophetic than many people have first thought.
No, the answer to the question is no.
Ukraine.
No, sir.
With $1 billion, if you
don't
get rid of
that, is absolutely not true.
Right after the event, commentators didn't hold back.
That was a hot mess inside a dumpster fire, inside a train wreck.
Rich Lowry, editor of the National Review, told NBC that the evening was dispiriting and raised the need to cut off the microphones in these out-of-control moments. In an editorial released later, Lowry even noted that the president going, in his words, full Trump was in an effort to try and make his opponent crack. Instead, he notes, Trump turned in a performance that a lot of viewers will find unpresidential without getting the upside.
You use some high-minded language, I'm just gonna say it like it is. That was a show.
Mary appears to have agreed with the general consensus about the tone and manner of the debate, taking to Twitter to criticize Donald on his preferred social media channel. At one point, the president was asked whether he would honor the results of the ballot, and he said, "I'm urging supporters to go into the poll and watch very carefully. If it's a fair election, I am 100% on board."
But if I see tens of thousands of ballots being manipulated, I can't go along with that.
Mary immediately called him out, tweeting, "He's being allowed on national television to sow uncertainty about the upcoming election. Everything he just said is a lie. Everything. He is the fraud." She also referred to the president as a traitor when he took aim at Beau and Hunter Biden, the former vice president's sons. She wrote, "Interrupting Vice President Biden's comments about his son Beau to pivot to lies about Hunter Biden should alone totally disqualify Donald. What a disgrace. What a traitor." Mary also took aim at her uncle over his comments about the suburbs. The mortgage note pointed out that suburban America became an issue when Trump rescinded the Obama era's affirmatively furthering fair housing rule, which guaranteed that everyone had a right to equal housing opportunities, but which the president has also said, quote, took away decision-making from local communities. Trump brought up the issue first, saying that, quote, the suburbs would be gone with Biden in charge, a claim Biden took as a racist dog whistle.
Like
he would know a suburb unless he took a wrong turn.
And when Trump attempted to explain, Biden cut in and said, "Suburbs are by and large integrated. There are as many people today driving their kids to soccer practice and are black and white and Hispanic in the same car as there have been at any time in the past. What really is a threat to their suburbs and their safety is his failure to deal with COVID. They are dying in the suburbs. His failure to deal with the environment. They are being flooded. They are being burned out because his refusal to do anything. That is why the suburbs are in trouble." Mary responded simply by saying, quote, "Bye, suburbs," her take on Donald Trump's attempt to win over the suburban housewives vote. Mary also took issue with moderator Chris Wallace, who at moments seemed to have lost control over the debates.
No, we're done, sir. We're moving on to the next. We're
moving on to the administration.
One journalist tweeted, "People are hating on Chris Wallace, but I think there was no way to moderate this debate effectively." But Mary felt that Wallace could have been stronger and let the world know exactly how she thought he was doing, writing in a series of tweets, "Not one fact check. Not one. So Chris Wallace, both sides COVID. Unbelievable. Apparently, not only Donald thinks Joe Biden is currently the president, Chris Wallace does too. Sure, let's just let him keep lying about everything." Mary left no thought in anyone's mind that the debates made her feel more charitably towards her uncle. She tweeted, "The media need to stop giving Donald the benefit of the doubt. His debate performance was a grotesque combination of lies, racism, breathtaking callousness, and threats against our democracy." Check out one of our newest videos right here. Plus, even more list videos about your favorite stuff are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.